A month ago, I went to one of the meetings that Fred and Caitlin organized to talk about their initiative. A couple of weeks after that, I went to...
Louder, we can't hear you.
Get closer to the mic, Steve.
A couple of weeks after that, I went to two of the on-the-table meetings with the Silicon Valley Community Foundation. I'd written a paper with Emma Emmett that started that. Last week, I went to a meeting with 40 legislators talking about housing in California. Yesterday, I went with Michael to the Bay Area Council Economic Institute to talk about their housing affordability study. So I have heard all of the hot button issues from various perspectives. But two things that I heard in all those meetings were much, much, much more important. And that is, opposed to a grand bargain, it sounds like people with disparate views grudgingly agreeing to a set of things, some from table A, some from table B. I heard massive common agreement in many of the buckets that Denise and Michael talked about, reducing costs, reducing barriers about delay, getting more money for affordable housing, changing the fiscal incentives. And I've got to say that the grand bargain piece to me, I know you don't mean it, Fred and others, but it feels like Congress, if you don't agree with me, I'm going to pick up my marbles and go home. Wouldn't it be wonderful if maybe you didn't resolve all of the hot button issues, but you had massive move the needle areas of agreement that you could put out there, whether or not or however you agreed with the hot button issues? It sounds like this is focused more on getting to agreement on the sticky stuff than in putting out the stuff that moves the needle. The second thing that I heard in Denise, it's the one thing that's confirmed, but it didn't jump out. Every place I went, they talked about public lands. You've got an item here. They talked about teacher housing. They talked about missing middle housing. Not condos that I like to live in, not subsidized units like we all want, but all of those massive people in the middle who struggle with affordability almost as much as people who are poor. So it's inferred in your list, Denise, but I think teacher housing is in area that everybody could agree on and get behind, and Steve and MPC and all of you could have something specific. And it wouldn't touch all the hot issues. So thanks.